Hello. Just another quick video. I want to show you how I make swarm traps. It's the middle of May. Bees are swarming all over the place. And swarm traps are the easiest, lowest effort way to get fresh swarms. So first we'll talk about the materials you need for these swarm traps. You need an old frame of brood, or an old brood frame. The blacker the better. This isn't quite bad enough or dirty enough for my liking, but it'll do for now. The dirtier it is, the more the bees are attracted to it. You need 2 14-litre or 15-litre buckets. In Ireland, these are widely available in the large hardware stores, and they're very cheap. They're like less than €2 each. Sometimes you can get them for €1 each. Sale, they'd be 5 for €5. So this is an old one. This is one I used last year for a swarm trap, and inside there you can see that the bees have built a little bit of comb in there. For I've taken it out at this stage, I've left some of it behind. There's some propolis stains around the edge of it here where they were putting down propolis, and all of this is deliberately left dirty because it gives the bees a kind of a smell of a hive to attract them. This bucket here is brand new, we bought a couple of days ago. Okay, apart from that, you need a couple of screws. Well, maybe one screw will be enough, but I have 2 here in case I need them. A few small cable ties. I have 4, I might only need 2. A little jar of lemongrass oil. Lemongrass oil, it's not lemon balm, not lemon citrus, not lemongrass, it has to be lemongrass. And that's all the materials you need. Tools, very simple. Piece of sandpaper. You might not even need the sandpaper, but it's handy to have it. Screwdriver, that's for screws. And a pair of pliers. So let's get stuck in. The first thing you need to do is take your pair of pliers and take the handles off the buckets. In this case, I only have to take off one of them because I only have one bucket. Well, one new bucket. Okay, that's the handle taken off. You want to roughly straighten it out. It doesn't have to be perfectly straight. Take off this piece of black plastic. So, we have straightened out the handle. Next thing I'm going to do is turn this handle into a hook. Like so. So, get your brood frame and skewer it with this hook. So, one of your buckets, sorry, I left out one piece of the instructions, lemongrass oil. You only want to use 1 drop of this. If you use more than 1 drop, there'll be too much of a smell out of it. So I'm just going to put 1 drop on the top bar of this frame here. Here we go. So we get our buckets next. One bucket like so. And another bucket like so. And these buckets have a hole in the rim where the handle was secured on. We're going to put a cable tie through that hole. Together. that is pretty much all you need to do to build your swarm trap. Now, to make things a little bit better, I'm going to put a screw in here. Now, the hook goes down here, goes across this way and up here. So I'm going to put the screw in there so that the hook is pretty much secured in position by the screw. It can't slide from side to side because the screw will prevent it from doing so. This gives you a 28 litre cavity with all of the things that bees like. They like it dark, they like very small entrances. So there is a few little cracks around the entrance here. And they like it about 30 to 35 litres would be ideal probably, but 28 is about as good as I can get using cheap, commonly available materials. And this works extremely well. Now, if you think that the gaps are sealed up too well, you can wedge something into the bottom here. Here we go. Here's a pebble. It's about 10 millimeters across, and I'll just wedge that into this space here. That'll give you a 10 millimeter opening. That's probably a little bit too much. Something like a 6 millimeter, or 6 millimeters would be better than 10, and that'll allow the queen in, and it'll give them a little bit more, make it darker inside, make it easier for them to defend. That's what they're looking for. Somewhere this, they're not going to get wet or cold. And now there's one more thing about this swarm trap. You can just put another hook top here. You can hang this up in a tree, you can push it into some bushes, you can tuck it up in the corner of a roof of a shed or something like that. You can literally put these almost anywhere, and they're ridiculously cheap to make, like about €5 to make one. And it's a piece of a frame that you were probably going to clean off and throw away anyway. So I hope this is useful, and I hope catch a few swarms using it. That's all.